Manchester United. I don't want to worry or upset any Manchester United fans, but it has nearly been a decade since the last time the Red Devils won a Premier League title. Last season, Manchester United overachieved, and I mean that in the best way possible. Coming into last season, there was little to no hope that the Red Devils would be able to pull through and finish as high as they did. Most people predicting to the Premier League standings put them at 5th place. They hadn't signed any of their priority signings, and the frustration around the Glazers and Ole grew immensely. However, as previously shown, Ole is at the wheel. The Norwegian manager rallied the troops and went on an amazing run that saw them finish second. The atmosphere around the club is very different this season. They have signed two of their preferred signings in Varane and Sancho, pretty much swiftly this transfer window. Whereas many people believe that the Red Devils are one centre defensive midfielder turning away from going into a title run, I think that it will take them 2 to 3 extra moves until we see them as Kings of England once again. As always in this series, we go to the manager. My question for Ole is, when are you going to stop being stubborn? Not quite fair for a manager who has been to what, 5 semi-finals now, made a trip to a Europa League final, and finished second with a squad that had no business finishing that high. Pretty impressive, but still no titles, no silverware to show for that hard work, and this is where I am coming from. Ole at times looks like a genius, at times he looks like he can go head to head with any manager in the Premier League. However, that is only sometimes, because most of the time Ole makes questionable decisions, keeping Van de Beek in the bench, even though he could add much needed creativity in the midfield, burning out Bruno when, once again, you have Van de Beek in the bench, overplaying Rashford, sticking to McFred against more defensive positions, sticking to Maguire and Lindelof even though at times they are a below average pairing. These are the things that make Ole a stubborn manager and which will keep him from winning anything as a United manager, unless he changes his approach. Fair play to Ole for sticking to his football morals and values, but that alone will not get you titles. You need to learn from your mistakes and avoid repeating them. If Ole unlocks this key in the team, if he can see the patterns of where things aren't going well and change that in time, then United are well on the way to have a fantastic season. United will not win the Premier League this season. This is simply due to the fact that they still have not addressed the main problem in the team, a hole that is exploited by the big teams and thankfully avoided by more defensive opposition, and that is the defensive midfielder problem. For about 6 years now, United have been dying for proper, in his prime, ball playing defensive midfielder. Signing Sancho is amazing, but it should have been done last summer, and United's problem have not been goal scoring for some time now. Varane improved the team 10 times over, but even in their defence wasn't that bad last season. The midfield defensive area, however, has been below average for some time. If United had someone to unlock Pogba, then the conversation would be much different. But having to play Pogba off the wing because you can't trust Fred and McTominay to do their job is scary. Fred and McTominay literally do the job of one man. But let's say that for some reason this was not a problem, or that Ole fixed this during the season. United would still not win the league because of a lack of depth. You take out Bruno and Pogba and United's midfield is not better than Southampton's. You take out Jadon Sancho off the wing and you are forced to play either Daniel James or Jesse Lingard, who with all respect in the world are not players that are going to win you the title. Whereas the likes of Liverpool, Chelsea and City not only have better starting 11s ready to go, but they also have depth, which is essential to have in a league where every game could really go either way. The dip in quality in the team after a few players come off resembles nothing of a title winning squad. Even by signing a proper defensive midfielder, it would still be hard to do much about it if the squad does not have depth and can't handle the big situations. My next dilemma at United is, can Bruno Fernandes, Pogba, Sancho, Greenwood, in short, their best players, come through with goals throughout the entire season? Last season, Bruno had an incredible season, player of the year worthy, but will he be able to do that again this season while at the same time the likes of Mason, Sancho, Rashford, Cavani and Martial coming through too? If so, then the depth problem becomes something less important if the goals are coming through. Can the new signings create an instant impact at the club? Varane was brought in to reproduce a fraction of what Van Dijk was able to do at Liverpool. Can Varane really be that guy? I think that he can be that guy and a little bit more. However, will all his stubbornness get in the way, and how long will Varane take to adapt to the team? Will the learning curve involve a few crucial points dropped during the season? And Sancho, after United went through so much trouble to sign him, how fast will he make his presence known? Both of these players are world-class players who once established will propel United immensely. But when is that when? If you're talking about a title run, things must be resolved before the end of September. But that leads me back to the first problem I talked about in the video, Ole's stubbornness. United's defence got a massive boost with the addition of Varane and the individual performances of Luke Shaw and Maguire at the Euros. I still believe that Varane will get the best out of Maguire and that will make them have an amazing season, however my problem is how long will that take? The goalkeeper problem is also something to look at. How will De Gea and Henderson behave behind the sticks and how will Ole manage them? United have a chance of doing better than last season. I don't think in terms of winning the league or going on a legit title run, but by cementing their place in the top 4, playing much better football and winning a cup or even doing something special in the Champions League. Best case scenario for United, they win the league. Ole opens his eyes and somewhere manages to fix the problems in the midfield. Bruno, Sancho and Varane have all stand up individual campaigns, with Mason scoring 20 goals plus once again in all competitions and Pogba playing at that world class level we all know he's capable of. What I think will happen, United will not win the league but will finish comfortably within the top 4 with Liverpool, Chelsea and City. Varane and Sancho will have a big impact on the team but only as the season progresses and not instantly like most people think. Worst case scenario, United will finish outside the top 4. Ole is sacked before Christmas and Varane and Sancho have to wait a year to prove themselves, as well as Pogba running down his contract in the worst possible way. Thank you very much for watching the video until the end. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more game analysis, football history, individual performances, top 10s, etc. This is the beginning of something special and it would mean the world to me if you subscribed and helped me to grow this channel.